At the Paris Air Show, Concorde appeared to make its usual demonstration, accompanied by the second prototype of the Tu-144. This new design exhibited many radical changes. It now had forward retractable canard wings to help it at subsonic speeds, and the engines were now spaced further apart. This was to be a tragic day for the Soviet team. Whilst going through its display routine, the aircraft climbed and then dived. During the dive, it appeared to suffer problems. Although it has never been ascertained as to exactly what happened, the pilot, M.K. Kuzlov, had appeared to try and pull out of the dive to avoid a Mirage jet fighter, then another dive and pull up again. On the last maneuver, the aircraft lost a wing and broke apart, plummeting to Earth. 14 people were killed in the disaster, including all six on board the aircraft. The debris and carnage spread for miles around the northern Paris suburb of Goussainville. Although it was not directly connected with the Soviet crash, Concorde suffered severe setbacks during 1973. Daunted by the high running costs and the lack of profitability in carrying 100 passengers, when a jumbo carried over 400, many of the world's airlines dragged their heels and cancelled preliminary orders. Pan Am, Qantas, Japan Airlines and TWA all backed out of buying. It now seemed likely that no more Concordes would be sold beyond the ones to Air France and BOAC.